Basically, volume on the TV had to start coming up. I started saying what to my wife, and start saying, "You need to look at me when you're talking to me. I can't hear you when you're looking into the kitchen sink." Always the challenge is, you know, a restaurant, a big gathering where a lot of people and you have background noise, with a hearing device that picks all of that up. So that was learning to try to filter through that and hear the conversation across the table from you. And it got to the point where we'd go to dinner with friends and they'd say, "Oh, we can't go there because it's so noisy. Bob can't hear us." And I said, "Let's back up a little. I'm going for the food. If it's a good restaurant, I'll put up with it." So it was that sort of thing. And then just word definition. I could tell my wife was talking to me or people were talking to me, and I would pick up a word here and there, but I couldn't define the whole sentence. Yeah, you're straining all the time to try to hear, and you know it's a nuisance to say what to people all the time, or especially if I'd be driving in the car with a customer, I'd find have to say, "You need to turn and look at me instead of looking at the windshield when you're talking to me, because I hear you so much better if you'll turn. I'll keep my eyes on the road. You look at me." And my wife with the same thing. I said, "Honey, turn and look at me." To a certain extent, yes. As I'd worked for the company for 32 years, and my father, who retired from the same industry, asked him, "Dad, when do you know when it's time to retire?" He said, "You'll wake up one day and go, it's time." And so I had turned 65 in July. This was, you know, I retired the following January. Our company was going through some massive changes, and I'm going, I'm really straining to hear critical stuff. I'm on the school board of a small Christian school in our town. We have board meetings every week, so that became over time a challenge to hear people across the table. Everybody's voice is different. Some people are very articulate. Some people words run together, which was my challenge. And then some people like to put their hands up in their mouth when they're talking. Your audiologist worked on fine-tuning the Envoy and really did the best job of any that worked on it to get the maximum for me.
Right.
But we could see that I was hitting the ceiling, so to speak, where this is the best we could do with it. So you said, "You may be a candidate for a cochlear implant. Let's have a screen. We'll screen you for it." And sure enough, and so I thought, well, I haven't got anything to lose. Let's go for it. The surgery was a slam dunk. It was almost painless. I took the pain medication for 36 hours and then quit. You know, I think that cochlear implant surgery is a lot easier than oral dental surgery. I had wisdom teeth extracted when I was in the service. That laid me up 24 hours. This didn't, you know. I was up and at it. I had the bandage off my head before we got home. Right. In the seminar, I was told that do not expect immediate, wonderful hearing results. You may hear anything from voices that sound like Donald Duck or Mickey Mouse, or sound that comes from a Star Wars movie, beeps and blurps. When you first turned it on here in this office, it felt like I had my head underwater and I had a lot of gurgling and bubbling and sounds going through water. But, you know, by the time I drove home in 2 hours, it had diminished considerably. And each day since the turn on, my hearing gets better.
That's great.
word definition gets better. I know I'm not there. It's a learning curve. But I'm very optimistic. I mean, and I expected mentally, okay, this is going to take a long time because your situation is your situation and it's not going to be a miracle overnight. Well, I used to couldn't hear my own car signal on. My wife was constantly saying, your turn signal's on. I could never hear it. I'd turn it on, but if I didn't look down and see it flashing, I'd think it would shut off. Engines, I can walk in our garage and hear our freezer run, which I didn't know. I'm less and less using earphones to watch TV, especially talk shows. I'm great. I don't have to have an earphone at all because it's dialogue and I'm starting to hear the words in the dialogue. Recorded movies with background music, I'm still working on that. It's the voice sounds coming on better, but
it's been 2 weeks, right?
It's just been 2 weeks.
That's all right.